In this video, I'm going to explain why MongoDB and NoSQL are synonymous and why that might actually be a bad thing. I'm also going to share a few alternatives you can use if you want to use NoSQL, but you don't want to use MongoDB or you just want to broaden your knowledge. Right now, NoSQL databases have grown in popularity over the last decade, mostly due to the fact that developers can jump in on the back end without having to master or even learn SQL, hence their popular name, NoSQL. But it goes way deeper than that. You guys may or may not have noticed, well, I'm a little older, and I came up in a time where you would use a stack like the LAMP stack or the XAMPP stack. LAMP was Linux, Apache, MySQL, and PHP. There wasn't really JavaScript in the stack at all, so you had to know your PHP, you had to know SQL to deal with the database, you would have to know Linux to deal with the command line instructions that are required to understand how to set up your whole stack. It was a whole ordeal, and I'm not going to say it was bad. I enjoy doing that kind of thing, but for a lot of devs these days, they don't even need to know Linux or anything like that. They don't know how to set up an SQL server. And I'm not saying that's a bad thing, but all that to say, you can jump in right now these days with just JavaScript knowledge and build a full stack application. And that's just not something that was popular back in the day. So it puts me in a unique position having come from something like the LAMP stack and knowing these lower level languages and monolithic ways of building apps to nowadays, you just know JavaScript, you do your front end in a nice framework like React or Angular or Vue. You do your backend in Node, and you never have to touch any SQL if you're using something like MongoDB or other databases that provide, some type of direct interop with JavaScript. So getting back to MongoDB, it's not so arguably the most popular NoSQL database out there. It started off as just a basic JSON data store and has grown far beyond that. All that said, what if I told you that MongoDB was not the best NoSQL solution out there? What if I told you that the only reason it's synonymous with NoSQL is due to luck and marketing? And it may not even be the best tool for the job. MongoDB grew in popularity just as JavaScript did. Many developers may not realize this, but JavaScript is actually pretty new to the game as far as back-end development. Heck, it wasn't even the first choice for dynamic websites until just recently. Recently, as far as my age goes, despite being the only language native to the browser. So MongoDB was early to the game. As JavaScript started to blow up, MongoDB was right along with it. First with the main stack, which was Mongo, Express, Angular, and Node. Developers were able to build a dynamic website in JavaScript for the client side, and then using those same skills, jump on the back end. You no longer needed a monolith like PHP or Rails to build something substantial. You could use JavaScript front to back, full stack. Which is probably where that phrase came from. There's no need to learn object-oriented programming, object-oriented design, DBA, LMNOP, yabba-dabba-doo, or bippity-boppity-boop. You could just jump in with JavaScript and get the job done. Easy peasy. Later, as React became the new hotness, instead of the main stack, people started talking about the MERN stack, which is, obviously, MongoDB, Express, React, and Node.js. Now, honestly, I can't tell you if MongoDB is the best NoSQL database or not. There's always pros and cons. Everything's a double-edged sword. All I can tell you is there's a plethora of other options available to you. And it doesn't matter if it's because you don't like MongoDB because there are various security snafus that have come up over the years, or if you just want to learn something new. Okay, so I don't want to get too technical in this video because I just want to give you a broad overview of a few of the plethora of options out there. I've picked five that I want to discuss. First being, of course, MongoDB. We want to talk about its features so that we can compare that with the rest of the field. First, let's talk about a standard SQL database. You may understand an SQL database as having tables and columns. It's pretty much it. You have a table or multiple tables. Each table has columns. Each column is a certain type defined by that particular database or depending on what that database supports. They're all pretty much the same. Those are called relational database management systems. They're very rigid. And in that rigidity comes reliability. And one of the problems that comes with that is sometimes when you try to scale out a large website that's doing a lot of things at one time, it starts to fall over. So this is actually where NoSQL even came from in the first place. This is something that grew out of the need for a more scalable and more flexible database. Within the NoSQL spectrum, you have databases that all don't use SQL, but there are slight differences in how you interact with your data. So with MongoDB, it has it's known as a document store. So it has collections and documents. To draw a parallel to your SQL, that's just a table, a collection, and a document or a record within that table or a row. You have other options, Google Cloud Firestore. This is actually a hosted solution. So you can't take Firestore with you somewhere and deploy it on Amazon or deploy it on DigitalOcean or something. You sign up at Firebase and you use Firestore. And this is also a document store. So it also has collections and documents. And the way you interact with Firestore is actually on the client side. You can access it from the back end. So you have, if you have a node back end or whatever else you have, but primarily with Firestore, the trick is that Firebase is the back end. You use a client side library in your client code and you can directly talk to your Firestore database, document database. The next in the line that I want to talk about is FaunaDB, which is an interesting one because it is described as not only a document store, but also a graph database, a relational database, and a time series database. So it's very flexible in what it's able to do. I haven't used it in any major products, but it looks very interesting. It has a free tier, so feel free to give it a try. It also appears to be a cloud-hosted solution. Sign up on their site and then use it in your local code. Cassandra. Cassandra is considered a wide column store. So that pretty much means it's you have tables and columns and rows, but it's way wider than what you would consider useful in an SQL database. Also, it doesn't have a schema. These are, you know, you can dynamically generate these rows and columns, and it's pretty popular NoSQL database outside of the JavaScript web developer world. Last but not least, we have DynamoDB. Now, DynamoDB is owned by AWS, Amazon. And it is a cloud solution. You can download a version of DynamoDB and use it for local development, but you cannot deploy it anywhere. You would have to then use Amazon for your production deployment. And I actually like DynamoDB a lot. There's a lot of resources out there for DynamoDB. There's a lot of talks that Amazon has put out to kind of give you an idea of how to use it. It is also billed as a document store, but also a key value store. Key value just means if you think of a JavaScript object, you have a key, you have a value. Well, DynamoDB falls into that category as well. However, obviously, you also can use it as a document store. That's definitely one to look into. So one of the reasons I got into DynamoDB, actually, it started me looking into other NoSQL databases. If you go through the Dynamo docs from Amazon, they really get into detail about how to use NoSQL in general, and they kind of turn a lot of the assumptions about NoSQL on their head. And that's a topic for another video. So if you want to know the technical reasons behind why you would choose NoSQL, how to properly use it and not end up like a lot of these people you see posting these blogs about how they'll never use Firestore or they're dropping Dynamo or they're done with MongoDB. Most of those people failed because they didn't understand how to properly use these technologies. If you want to see that video, leave me a comment or give me a like on the video. I'll go ahead and make that happen for you guys. If you have some feedback on NoSQL or if you have any other databases that you've used that you want to recommend, feel free to drop me a comment, hit me up on Twitter. Once again, thanks for stopping by. This is Rock Codes. I'm out. Peace.